It's possible. So it's a long answer.
No, just one last comment. But given yesterday of 2004, December, I went through one of those moments that you call this crazy moment. I don't know what. I know what caused it, but I was in that point where I was trying my dance, but I couldn't. And through, I would say, a chance. A chance that I wanted to do for 20 years and I didn't do it. Don't ask me why, that's how it happened. I discovered a place where I could get some answers. One of the things that I learned about, because then I went to study human mind and everything else, one of the things I learned was that we get approximately 2,000 plus conditions before the age of 2. These conditions are totally invisible to us. We don't know, we don't remember, we don't know we have it. We carry them for the rest of our life. These are the ones that are dangerous to the community to lead them. And there is a way, and it takes 3 to 5 years. That's what I've done. Anyway, thank you so much.
May I say something, but I ask you to use my Romanian language just to be more precise, please, and I translate to you after. Există ceea ce se numește prezența de spirit, avem și în limba română. Prezența de spirit este o stare de grație care se instalează la un moment dat când nu mai cred că poate să o fac ceva, nu când poate să o fac. Deci, dacă știu să fac această chestionare permanentă a unei probleme, voi ajunge la situația că nu pot rezolva. Am spus la treaba aceasta, de exemplu, ca model, ca paradigmă, dacă vreți, sau ca parabolă, vreau la mama. Imaginați-vă că, în general, copilul este foarte zburtan, nu are nicio treabă, uitați și care mama ta se joacă. Se lovește, începe să curgă prima dată sângele și fuge la mama. Deci, când nu avem soluție, mergem la o orientață de altă factură, se oprește tot ce sursă de cunoaștere și atunci apare acel moment, acea Drăgănescu, modelul lui de ortofizică, spune a fire, e ființarea ideii. S-ar putea nici să nu o pot conștientiza, dar ea lucrează, se desface. E ca un fel de program zipuit, pe care în timp, treptat, mintea, îl poate dezipui, la vădare și revelația, și pe poate și folosi. Se numesc cele 3 drepte, a fire, a ști și a spune. Dar pentru asta trebuie să pot să-mi regenerez permanent, nu să merg pe o abacă. Am învățat niște definiții și eu compar realitatea cu abaca. Nu, mi-o construiesc mintea permanent. Nu e un proces simplu, dar este posibil. Și deja există tehnici sau, în orice caz, avea o bază extrem de importantă că ceea ce s-a spus este în firea fiecăruia și închei cu observația că marile descoperiri s-au făcut în partea noastră. S-a luptat, a încercat, a muncit, nu s-a întâmplat nimic, n-a rezolvat, a plecat într-un moment de pauză de valo spectacol și a venit dintr-o dată toată cunoașterea. Și a scris pe manșeta de la haină, de la cămașă, rezultatul, statea condiții. Deci, cu alte cuvinte, avem ce întreba și spune mai departe. I shall discuss with you tomorrow morning about this idea of presence of spirit that I try to explain to them because I had the chance to have some a sort of background in which I can say something about this a sort of answer of the question. Other kind of question, please. We need a silent mind, but not so silent, please. Not so silent.
You see, this is precisely the situation. This idea that silent mind is not enough.
We have a great artist, Brancusi, it's in our language, and he said simplicity is a solved complexity. So we need to rise the mind to this let's say, perception to redefine the vocabulary, the meaning, the meaning of the words, just to be capable to bring a breakthrough to this kind of understanding.
As far as I remember, Brancusi used to also to say that the sculpture he was doing it only by getting rid of the matter. That there is this wonderful sculpture that he could, let's say, do, I don't know, where done with all carvers are working like that. They are working by taking things out. So can we do the same with the mind? Then we become meditative Brancusi.
Okay, so my question is exactly this, as you were saying, the fact that you're discussing about understanding that there is something beyond the conditioning of the mind, but understanding is with the mind, and by trying to find out, by putting the question, and is this actually silence? I mean, it is not in a way silence, because we are still using the mind, we are using words and thoughts, and it's a striving to do that. And how can you do this without a striving? And how can you actually find out the unconditioning with the instrument that you create the conditioning with? So that's my question.
It's very simple and difficult at the same time, but it's quite simple. Thinking is an action. Most of the time, when we use the thought, we use it in such a way that it brings confusion. So first thing is to use the thinking to go as deep as possible into a question, not bringing confusion. That is like a laser. You know laser?
Yeah.
Just following, not going here and there. Following. The moment the thought is no more going here and there, it brings a lot of energy. Now, the big thing is not only acting. The big thing is listening. That is, when you question, the active part must be very clear. That is, once again, not going here and there, but keeping with the point. When you do that, this movement of questioning brings a particular quality of force or energy. At the same moment you're questioning, it is absolutely needed to be, when I say listening, I mean to be sensitive, to be deeply aware of what is going on through the questioning. Because you're right, the thought will stay into his movement, that is cause and effects, consequences. But the moment the thought is no more waving here and there, when the thought is, let's say, concentrate is not the correct word, but focus, when the thought is focused, it brings a quality of, energy, life. If you listen to this, if you sense this, the thing which is sensing it is what we call consciousness. Not the thinking, not the mind, but how could we call it? This, let's say just this thing, so it's simple. This thing which is listening is consciousness. And the particularity of consciousness is that it doesn't belong to you. It belongs to nobody. It's the only common point of whole life, of whole species, of everything. Thinking is always personal. Now, if the thinking, once again, is very focused, there is this quality that shows up. What really brings suffering is the disturbance of the thinking, when the thinking is going here and there and there and there, and you don't follow or you don't deepen the point. Deepening the point does not mean that you will find a final answer. Deepening the point releases a quality of energy. Now, this is a little bit technical now, but the listening of this energy is what we call consciousness. And this process of the consciousness listening to the movement of energy, this is what I call meditation. At the moment the thought is waving, it's no more. You can't, it's impossible. Because when the thought is going here and there, it's only the conditioning mind which is operating. And it's very difficult to make a cut into the conditioning process. But even though it's difficult, it is possible. And it's quite, I'm sorry to say that, it's quite simple. I'm sorry because it might sound uneasy to hear.
Which is the state of mind in which we can heal our physical body? Meditation mind?
Yeah.
With a specific focus or
no.
Just... Thank you.
Welcome.
I would like to know how is it your state of mind you are living with mostly in? Do you still have the inner talk or not? Do you choose your thought and keep it? How is it inside your mind?
I have no mind.
Love you.
What do you mean? I don't understand you. Because I'm very, very simple-minded. Tell us again. I'm not sure if I understand.
For most of us, we have this inner talk, which is constantly saying,
uh-huh.
Look, this means that, and it gives you direction, impressions, labels, everything. I was wondering if in your mind you still have this inner talk or not.
Oh, I see.
So once again, this is the comparison. It's a kind of comparison in between, let's say, the chattering thinking and a silent mind. Only the chattering thinking can compare. The silent mind is unable to compare. So it's unable to make any kind of hierarchy. You understand? Nothing is more valuable than anything else. Now, the chattering mind is very conditioned again, so that was the big question. Is there something radically different? So, what I can say today is that, yes, there is something radically different. But the silent, let's call it mind, is not something personal, and its main quality is sensitivity. And this sensitivity brings about a perception of unity, that there is no division. When this is operating, what we call the chattering mind is included into unity. Chattering mind is not a problem. It is a problem in itself, because it brings division. But we could say that Florin was talking about, if I well understood, unity and diversity, that's it. So that's it. It doesn't mean to exclude anything. It's a quality